tech analyst Ian Wishengrad is here. And Ian, you and I were listening to Deirdre's report, and certainly these companies, Twitter everybody knows, Facebook everybody knows, but this Gab.com, few people had heard of until what happened in Pittsburgh. They've come under scrutiny. Now Gab is gone. What happens next?
Well, I feel like this is always a game of whack-a-mole. So Gab was started, by my understanding, from a conservative programmer who was not pleased with how certain algorithms were treating hate speech in Silicon Valley and felt like it was a very liberal bias. So he went out and started Gab.com and brought in all the disenfranchised, all the people that were kicked off the other platforms.
Now that it's gone, someone else could do the same thing.
Absolutely, and it just keeps, it will keep reemerging. I think you can't stop people who want to convene and discuss things from doing so.
Now the numbers are much lower. Deirdre talked about them, 650,000 users versus hundreds of millions or billions in the case of Facebook, I guess, but it's it still gets the information out there, which I assume is kind of the goal of these people, is to have some sort of a platform.
Sure, but I think there's a difference here, because if you saw what happened with the bomber situation, he was on Twitter trolling people, trying to engage. He was trying to work with the main public. The Gab.com group is a bunch of like-minded people that just seem to, you know, hang around and hate together. So they're kind of just preaching to their own choir.
So what's the responsibility then from people you talk to, or what are the conversations, I wonder, at these companies that are larger? So you're right about Twitter. The person who's been cited, and there may be other examples of this, was a political pundit that appeared here on Fox and other places, who says that she was threatened by this man, who she thinks was him, on Twitter, among other things, hug your loved ones very closely the next time you leave your house, that kind of thing. She reported it, this woman, and Twitter basically said, hey, listen, that doesn't violate our terms of service. That's the story that she's told.
Sure. So. Well, there's a few things at play. So number one, the social networks have to deal with scale, billions of people making comments.
Right.
It's really hard to police that situation.
But in this case, they did have a report. So when they do get a report officially from someone, then they must deal with it in some way, right?
Sure, and I feel like they probably get more reports than actions by far. So maybe there's a system to be put in place to start flagging and sending to the right officials, you know, a danger or something to be paid attention to here. But the bigger issue is that those platforms have to, or try to do their best to make a safe environment, because they make all their money from advertising dollars.
Right.
And advertisers do not want to be adjacent to any of this hate content. The dangerous part about the Gab.com, or wherever the next version of it is that they're there just to spread their own beliefs. They're not there to make money, which makes them almost more dangerous.
They don't have the same motivation.
Correct, not at all.
That's really interesting, because there will be another Gab.com. There will be some version of that, especially if Twitter and Facebook, but Twitter in this case is being looked at, if they clamp down even more, there's your motivation to come up with another vehicle like this.
And that's kind of what happens. You know, it used to be one social network wasn't cool, which gave room for another one.
Right.
And now to somewhat other people, the place that's not safe for them, or not safe, but not friendly to their words, will then go escape somewhere else. And I think it's a giant game of whack-a-mole. Yeah. Ultimately, the free speech didn't kill people. You know, it was definitely, unfortunately, the weapons that did.
The person had those weapons. The person killed the people, not the... No, you're right about that. But it's an interesting discussion, and one that these companies, I assume, will continue to have. Ian, thanks a lot.
Thank you for having me
today.